Hey guys, what up? Casey here, and today we're going to continue on with the How to Use Etrade Pro series, and today we're going to be talking about charting. First things first, as you can see, the setup has changed a little bit. I did get rid of the chart just so I can start all over for you guys today. So first things first, you guys, there are two different types of charts. There's the classic ones and there are the normal ones. If you go to the classic ones, this is what it will look like. As you can see, the other one is the newer model. It does recommend that you replace it with the new chart. So, and since I use the new one and I don't really like this one, we're going to be doing all of our charting today on the new one. So we're going to go ahead and get rid of this. I don't like this one, but if you do, please feel free to use it. It works the exact same way. I prefer how the other one looks. So we're going ahead and open up the other chart. And this is what you look like, just a white screen. Nice. Okay, no, that's not true. This is what it looks like right here. So first things first, I'm gonna be showing you guys the intraday trading chart. I use three of them. So I use the 1 minute, the 3 minute, and the 5 minute candles. So first things first, we click the 1 day. And this is the one, it automatically sets it at the 1 minute chart. So first things first, this is what it looks like if you were to zoom in on it. If you're doing intraday trading, you can turn on extended hours as well as previous clothesline. Well, you can always do the previous clothesline. But the extended hours does show your aftermarket and your pre-market moves. I prefer to have those on. So I always have them on my intraday trading, but you guys can do however you prefer. I like it, so I recommend doing it. So here we go. This is the intraday chart for the 1 minute. First things first, I like to have the crosshair turned on. If you don't know this, the difference, if I move my mouse around right now, nothing happens. You don't see any numbers on the side, anything like that. So if you turn the crosshair on, it gives you the time as well as the price for that candlestick. I like that. Also, you will notice right here, it gives us all the information for that candle that we are hovering over. It doesn't matter where you are on it, but if you're hovering over a candle, it tells you what it opened at, the high, the low, the volume during that one candle, and everything like that, the price that it was at, and things like that. So I like to have the crosshair turned on. This is super helpful right here. As for the candles themselves, they automatically come in the hollow candle. I prefer having the normal candles turned on. I like having them filled. You guys can change the colors around and everything like that if you wanted to. How you do that is you go to themes and you go to custom theme. And then in your custom theme, you go to edit it. You can change the color, the wick, the border, the background of the actual chart, everything like that. I prefer to leave it on the dark one. I like how they have it set up. If you guys like the light one, I guess you can use it, but I think this app looks absolutely horrible, so I don't know how anybody could use that. I like the dark one, so this is the dark one that I have. In the 1 minute candle, or the 1 minute chart, I have only the VWAP study. So if you go to studies, the only one I use is the VWAP. That's the volume weighted average. I like this one. I recommend you have this one turned on. As you can see, it holds resistance and support pretty well for the most part. And this is a bigger, this is a higher price stock, so it holds it better. But if it were to break through, it could really start running in the low float market. So I always have the VWAP turned on. This is pretty much the basics of the 1 minute chart. I set up a couple more. I do all the exact same things in all of them, so we can rename them. 1 minute, the 3 minute, and the 5 minute. And then you could do one for all of them and just change them how you see fit. Wow, this is really taking a dump right now. Anyway, but I like having a separate chart for all of them so I can just quickly switch between them. Either way, they all have to be set up the same way. You have to go through all the time to set them all up, which is kind of annoying, so I'm not going to do it again in the exact same, like in one video. I'm not going to do all of them. They all work the exact same way when you're doing intraday trading. The other thing that is important are, where is it at? Oh, draw. So with this, if you click the draw button, there are different things. So if you're looking for support and resistance, you could just go down to a horizontal line and you can place it and say, I've seen this resistance at right here. This looks like a nice resistance at 162.75. So you can place it by just clicking on it and you can right click on it later, which will delete it. You can do horizontal lines. You can change how thick the lines are, the color. It can label on the axis. There are all kinds of different drawing techniques. You can do Fibonacci, you can do channels, which is like trends. So if you want to click it here and here, and then you can drag it down so you can say it was in this trend or this channel for a while, and then when it really broke it just took a dump. There's all kinds of different ways. I recommend you play with them, figure out what you like. I think notes is you can just type and be like, buy here, and you just save it. I mean, I don't really know how some of these work, but you can. There's all kinds of different drawing tools that you can use, so feel free to mess around, use them. Line is the exact same thing as the horizontal one, except that you can put it at an angle, which is nice if you want to custom draw these channels. Instead of having them be exactly equal, you can have them a little bit more accurate. If you want to get rid of it, you just click it, but you can make it a little bit more accurate when you have them separately, so that way they don't have to be perfect. But anyway, that's the basic of the charting right there. I am going to show you guys my 1 year chart. I have my 1, my 3 minute, and my 5 minute charts. But the other thing that I have set up is I have a 1 year over here. When I do the 1 year, I do 3 different studies. So all of them are moving averages. I do the 50 day, and I leave it with the close and the simple moving average. So there's the 50 day. And then you can do it again with the 200, and everybody uses different indicators. You're more than welcome to use any of the other indicators, or you can change around the ones that I use, do different average for days. There's different ones that are popular, but that now I have a 200, I have a 50 day, and the final one that I like to use is the 13 day EMA. So there's 2 different ways of going about the 13 day EMA. You can click the exponential moving average, which is exactly that. You just click this and you type 13, not that. And now you have the 13-day moving average. Or you can go to the studies and do just the moving average. And in moving average, there's all kinds of different options. You can use any of these. I don't really know what some of them do, but for making the exponential, you just do exponential and you make it 13. And this will cover up the old one. As you can see, they are on the exact same line. So if I click one of these and delete it, the other one will show up. So I have 2 of them there. Now there's only 1. But that's pretty much the basics of my 1 year chart. And then I link them all together, which we'll show you right here. But that's pretty much the basics of charting on ETrade Pro. If you guys have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment down below and I will get back to you guys as soon as possible and try to help you with figure anything out. Also, if you have any video suggestions on what to do or learning how to use ETrade Pro, please let me know. I'm starting a series on it, and I'm going to be putting out a ton of videos on how to use ETrade Pro platform as a whole. So that's pretty much it, guys. Thanks for watching, and see you guys next time.